Let's talk briefly about JSON serialization. We'll do some big picture discussion first and then see how to do serialization using a third-party library called JSON.net. When you send an object across a wire, you need to serialize it before you can transmit it. If you're going from an object into something like a string format, that's called serialization, and going the opposite direction is deserialization. The two most common text-based formats today are XML and JSON. Most servers will let you use either. In practice, JSON seems to be more common these days. If your server doesn't give you JSON by default, and that's what you want, you can include the accept header in your request to get back JSON formatted data in the response. The JSON format's pretty simple. It's just name value pairs as text. Here's an example. It's pretty compact, which means it's pretty performant. It's easy to parse. It's fast to send across the wire. It's also powerful enough to encode something like this example here, where we have a collection of objects as a single JSON string. And it's widely supported, so no matter what language, no matter what client-side technology you're using, there's likely to be one or more APIs that you can use to convert between objects and JSON strings. For Xamarin developers, there's two really popular choices. There's the one that's built into .NET, system.json. This is nice because it's built in. However, it's not easy to use from a PCL, and it doesn't quite have as many features as some of the third-party libraries. In particular, json.net has a lot to offer, and in practice these days seems to be extremely popular. It also includes PCL support, which means it's a pretty good choice for Xamarin developers, and it's the one that we're going to use in our example in just a minute. So it's available on NuGet. Just add it to each of your projects. JSON.net is a very large library. We're not even going to attempt to cover it all. We're just going to do two core operations, serialize an object and deserialize an object. To do that, we're going to use this simple JSON convert class. It just has a couple of static methods on it that makes this really easy. So we're going to use it to go in both directions. We're going to define the class, but then JSON.net does the rest. We'll do four examples. Here's the first one, single object to string. So I create my object in code, and then it's just one line, call serialize object, JSON convert, goes through the object, pulls out all the property values, and creates a JSON string for us. There's a similar example, just a tiny bit more complex. We're gonna start with a collection of objects. Again, it's just one call to convert the entire collection into a single JSON string. Going the other direction, we're going to start with a string. We're going to hard code the string, but that's the kind of thing you would get from a server as the result of a REST API call. It's one line of code, deserialize object, pass in the JSON string. The deserialize method will allocate a product object and populate the properties. And finally, we're going to do string to collection. So we'll start with a more complex JSON string that represents multiple objects. And once again, it's a single method call to convert them into a collection of objects.